Ever wished you just stayed at home? I'm Michael Lück, Associate Professor here at AUT School of Hospitality and Tourism. Tourism isn't just about sunning yourself in Honolulu. At AUT, we study the impacts of tourism all over the world. Recently, we've contributed to the research literature on polar tourism. It's really hot right now, but sometimes when you get there, it's so cold you wish you stayed home. Like November 2007. 154 tourists and crew got a whole lot more adventure than they bargained for when their cruise ship, the Explorer, sank in Antarctic waters. It brought new meaning to a type of trip they'd paid tens of thousands for. Last chance tourism, or doomsday tourism, is heating up interest in the coldest places on Earth. And doomsday felt close as they huddled for 5 hours in open lifeboats before being rescued. Antarctic water is so cold you'd die in minutes. Even some of its fish have antifreeze in their blood to cope with such extremes. Why go there at all? The poles have fascinated us for as long as we've known about them. The Antarctic is a frozen continent surrounded by ocean. The Arctic is a frozen ocean surrounded by continents. In summer, the Arctic's ice cap melts, 10 million square kilometers roughly halving in size. It's already floating, so the melt has no real effect on our sea levels. But Antarctica has 90% of all the Earth's ice. If its 29 million cubic kilometers ever melted, the world's oceans would rise by 65 meters. The lower Arctic has been inhabited for thousands of years, while the Antarctic continent was only first sighted by man in 1820. By that time, Arctic tourism was in full swing, with tours to the ice cap aimed at enterprising knapsack adventurers. Antarctic tourism took another 150 years to kick off, with the 1969 launch of its first tourist cruise ship, none other than our ill-fated Explorer. The Explorer wasn't the first or the last cruise ship to get into trouble at the poles. In the 2 years to February 2009, three others had gone aground and another struck an iceberg. Similar incidents keep happening. It's been pure luck that other ships have been able to pick up the offloaded passengers. Passengers aren't the only things cruise ships offload. Each day, the average cruise liner produces 800,000 liters of grey water, which is the water from showers, sinks and galleys, 114,000 liters of black water, which is untreated sewage, and each week it produces as much as 50 tons of solid waste, much of it being pumped directly into the sea. Funnily enough, the vast majority of polar tourists see themselves as environmentally aware. 60% of them claim the experience has motivated them to help protect sensitive areas of the planet. And this once-in-a-lifetime experience is so good, a full 25% of them go back for more.